So since today we are discussing about investing in Greece, I think there is no more fitting way than to start this discussion after the introduction of Minister Georgiadis with a project that has been in the making for some time, at least in the planning phase, a project that will have a transformational impact on Greece and its economy. And this is the Hellinikon project. So we have with us here the major stakeholders in that project, most of them, and they will take us through the project. I will turn it over to Mr. Kourniotis from Lambadarios law firm to make the introductions. Again, thank you, Minister. Thank you, Odisseas, Konstantinos, for being with us.
Thank you.
Thank you, Nico. It's not only a pleasure, it is an honor for me to participate to this panel and in the capacity of the moderator. Today, here, we'll have the man behind the script, the man behind the numbers, the man who made that success possible. We'll have the minister, we'll have the banker, and we'll have the CEO. And of course, we'll be talking about the Hellinikon project that you just mentioned. The Hellinikon project development constitutes an investment of unprecedented scale and importance for Greece. It will be the biggest urban regeneration project in Europe once completed, including also the first integrated resort casino to operate not only in Greece, but further afield. It's a major, it's a symbolic project. And as we all know, I mean, the tender authority has recently received an impressive tender offer for the IRC. So the whole thing should be considered as a benchmark and an example for the potential economic operators willing to invest in Greece. The development of the Hellinikon project will not only affect, you know, the nearby area, but the Greek economy as a whole. It will foster relationships with banks, financing institutions, construction companies, service providers, and in that way, a great part of the Greek economy will have the opportunity to reap the benefits of this unique investment. The IRC project in particular covers a large and arguably the most critical part of the overall Hellinikon project, will be a link to the development of the overall project, and also that of the Metropolitan Park and the coastal front. It will definitely transform the lives of the Athenian residents and the visitors. Now it's about time to pass on the floor to the minister. Minister Papathanasis, you and your government has done a remarkable job. Not only you managed to go through all this hardship, not only you managed to further the project, but you managed to secure an offer of 150 million euros payable on day one. This is the most expensive casino license in the whole casino history. I mean, you understand that the project will be complex and the investment will be unprecedented. Is the Greek government determined to support the efforts of the investors in every way throughout the development of the project?
Thank you very much, Mr. Kourniotis. It is really a pleasure to be here with you today in the Capital Link Investment Forum. And of course, with such an interesting project to speak, the Hellinikon project. It's an emblematic project also. It is a pleasure to be in the panel with Mr. Athanasiou, the CEO of Lambda Development, and Mr. Vassiliou, the deputy CEO of Eurobank. Well, as we are a few days before Christmas, and actually we are in the heart of COVID-19 second wave, we are hoping that very soon the vaccination will let us free and to go back to the work we were doing, even though during this time the work has been continuing, is being continued as drastically and as virulently as we had been doing during the time before the virus. And of course, the Hellinikon project is such an emblematic project, and I would not like to go back to the year 2011 where it started, but rather I will go forward and run into the year 2019, where Prime Minister Kyriakos Mitsotakis pledged that his government would unlock the investment. And whoever followed this project, actually really would know that this project had been stuck with many problematic points. And it was our duty, and we did it as fast as possible with Minister Georgiadis to unblock the project and to be here today to discuss the time that this project will become real. This is a big investment, you understand, of an investment of such a scale is not an easy matter. Several state, regional, and municipal authorities had to be coordinated in order to prepare all everything that is necessary. So we ran, and I have to say that we had an excellent cooperation with Lambda in order to reach this particular project. The project is the largest urban regeneration project in Europe, and of course it aims to change not only Athens, but I would say Greece as a whole, since it signifies the turnaround of Greece and the importance we give to so important projects. So, of course, it will create new and well-paid jobs, it will boost our country's position in the tourism, innovation, entrepreneurship, and of course, it will contribute to our national economic growth. Now, according to the estimations, it will create 10,000 permanent jobs during the construction period and approximately 75,000 jobs at the maturity. That means it will be contributing 2.4% to the Greek GDP. Right now, the integrated resort casino in Spire Athens will be an investment of more than 1 billion euros, and it will feature a casino, a luxurious five-star hotel, a conference, an exhibition center, and a sports and cultural center with a capacity of approximately 10,500 people. The casino itself it will cover approximately 15,000 meters. Now, as I said, and as it is very important to realize that we have not stopped reforming the country, and this is an ongoing procedure, and we will continue to do that in order to make our country a success story in Europe, and of course a friendly country to investment. So in the question that you have made right from the beginning, we are trying to assist the project. We are trying to assist the investments in Greece. We are running with fast track processes, large investment. We're simplifying processes, we reduce steps. And of course, we outsource a lot of things that the state previously was done internally. And that will give us the speed we want to have in order to make the investors feel confident that this country has changed drastically. Now, we do provide tax incentives for the investments that come to Greece. And of course, with our fast track processes, make things as we did with a Hellinikon project. We make things happen quite fast. Recently, we announced a measure of 200 over depreciation for digital and green fixed capital investments for 3 years for 2021-23, and we will not stop providing incentives in order to make things happen in Greece. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Minister. You almost covered, you know, my second question, because, you know, the most important thing for such a complex and large-scale investment is, you know, the permitting and licensing process. I was just wondering, specifically on that and concerning, you know, their simplification, do you feel like having something to add on the top of what you said? Because that would be, you know, extremely important.
Yes, of course, we have an office. We have the Hellinikon Project Office that runs all the licensing and permitting procedures. And also we have introduced the term of independent engineer that will do all the work and the auditing, if you the auditing of the project. So we will not have, as I said before, we are outsourcing things that the state was doing before, and actually these procedures kept the projects in a low speed procedure. So we're outsourcing to the independent engineer the auditing of the project, and of course we have an independent office to give all the licensing and the permitting procedures. Yes, we do that in one stop shop. This is the term, and we do that also here in the ministry in the various strategic or emblematic projects we run.
It's very important. Your feedback is very important, and it will reach, you know, headlines tomorrow. One stop shop. I keep, you know, these words. So one final question. You know that for the entering into force of the concession agreement, there are certain, you know, conditions precedent, which somehow are also interrelated to the conditions precedent of the share purchase agreement that you have with Lambda. In terms of timing, can you please give us a rough estimate when we should expect, you know, all these things, you know, to come to fruition?
Okay, well, yeah, going back to the one-stop shop, this is something very efficient. We found that it's very efficient, and we are doing that. We are running a Hellinikon cooperation as a team weekly, so we follow exactly everything that is happening. Now, of course, you know that the works actually started last summer, actually, with the demolition of the buildings. Yes. All buildings have been demolished, and we believe that before the end of the first trimester of 2021, we'll have the actual beginning of the construction or the works before the construction. Of course, Mr. Athanasiou is more competent there, and will state exactly the date. But we are very close to what is called the beginning of the construction process.
That's really, really impressive. I will pass on the floor now to Mr. Vassiliou. I mean, we heard all these things from the minister. I mean, I understand that you, the Greek banks, you know, currently have underwritten the financing of this project. This is a vote of confidence for the ability of Lambda and the Greek state to assume the relevant responsibilities to do things on time, isn't it, Kostas?
It is. Thank you, Yannis. First of all, I would like to thank and congratulate Nick, Olga, and their team for organizing the 22nd Capital Link Investor Forum in New York, and under unique circumstances. And I do hope that we will all meet next year in New York on the 23rd conference. And I would also like to take this opportunity to thank you for coordinating this panel, and also to welcome Mr. Papathanasis and Mr. Athanasiou. And I'm really privileged and honored of being of the same panel with you. Now, regarding your question, I think it's a straightforward answer. Yannis definitely is a vote of confidence. You asked me if it's a vote of confidence for Lambda and the Greek state. The answer is yes, and I would like to with a simple argumentation to say that any banker's and any bank's job is primarily to review and assess business plans and projects. And business plans are numbers. The numbers and the business plans are always implemented by management teams. So people are the ones that make the different and skill set and management capability. And for us, it's always key in every single evaluation of analyzing the counterparty risk, as it's also very, very important in analyzing the macroeconomic risk, which applies to your question regarding if it's a vote of confidence to the government. Obviously, we wouldn't like to operate invest our depositors' money in a country that we wouldn't trust or we believe that on a long-term basis will remain strong, especially in this project, because this is a very complex and very difficult project. The analysis of the ability of Lambda development of its CEO and the overall management team, as this will be further and already actually enabled and enhanced with strong market professionals, it was key in our assessment. I'm sure Odisseas will confirm in the early days of assessing this project after we thoroughly review, scrutinized, and so we discussed with each other the numbers, and we had, I think, a very constructive debate between us and our teams. We said that we are okay with the numbers. Now, please let us know who is going to run the project. And obviously, we were totally happy with the answers we get. And actually, as you know very well, because you're a very experienced commercial legal counsel, actually, we even include contractual obligations in documentation regarding the key members of the management team, because this is key for any complex project. Regarding the state, for such a project with so many complexities, and you're all aware, it's really important to have the right framework in all means, from technical, zoning, the legal framework, to deal with all the issues around it. But most importantly is the stability of the country on the sovereign and macro fund, because this is a long-term project. It very much, its success rely in a great extent of selling part of the real estate and the residential units that will be built, but also commercial activities, which already some of them are successful. And actually nobody is gonna invest from large corporations such as the joint venture of Mohegan Sun and Yekterna, also the joint venture that Lambda recently announced with Temes Group, or individuals that would like to invest their long-term deposits in a residence here in Greece, if they don't believe in the long-term standing of the Greek state. So this is really important. This is what we assessed as well. And I don't need to say the obvious, since we underwrote this project, that we were fully satisfied with both.
That's great news. That's great news, Kostas. I always wanted you, you know, to ask the next question, you know, even at a personal level. I mean, recently, until recently, you know, the Greek economy was struck by a crisis. Despite that, and despite all we hear about the Greek banks kept on financing each and every project that was tendered out, including, you know, the refinancing of existing projects. I would love to hear, you know, what was the key to that success? Was it, you know, the Greek ingenuity to thrive, you know, with limited resources? Was it the banking know-how? Was it the IFIs that they co-invested? Was it the government supportive? Can you please elaborate a little bit on that?
I think that we're just doing our job, nothing more or nothing less than that. You said before, and you were really kind, saying that we have in front of us the men behind the success of the project. I will not try to be humble to say that actually the two men and actually the institutions behind the success of this project, actually it's the Greek government and Lambda Development itself. Bankers, we are enablers. We are enabling and we accelerate of developing projects. So definitely we don't want to claim the success of the counterparties that they originate and they actually deliver the project. So I think what is the success is very, very simple. I think that not only Eurobank, but the Greek banks overall have the know-how and very experienced personnel in evaluating, assessing, executing and implementing such type of projects. This is the one stuff. But I think the most important thing is the commitment that the management of the Greek banks and all its personnel, but also its shareholders, private and non-private shareholders, demonstrate in this country and to the counterparties that they implement these projects. And I think that so far, this commitment and our view that Greece not only will survive through this crisis, but actually we have better days ahead, show ourselves operating in this country and investing our shareholders and our depositors' money in certain management teams, projects, and in a country like Greece proved correct because can greatly support our operations and the profitability of Eurobank and the other Greek banks here.
Perfect. And one very last question, and I will be a little bit cynical on that. We hear all these horror stories about the Greek banks, and I want a clear-cut answer. Do Greek banks have the liquidity and the funds to finance, you know, the privatization program of this government and the infrastructure program of this government? And is there any key message that you want to pass on to the international investors on that?
Okay, thank you for the question. I think it's a very a real question, and I would like to answer with facts and numbers. I think that the answer is clearly yes. And regarding liquidity, the liquidity just the last 9 months, the liquidity of the Greek banks in terms of actual deposits have been improved by 13 billion euros. If you're going to see a ratio that banks and investors actually evaluate is the loan to deposit ratio. Right now, all four Greek banks on a group basis have loan to deposit ratios well below 100%. This ranges between 65% to 95%, on average 80%, which means that we have more liquidity than actually the performing loan book. Liquidity is not only deposits, which is the most important part of liquidity because it's core liquidity, but is also access to capital markets through repos. And the repo market with international banks for a couple of years, if not more, is totally open for the Greek banks, is access to the regulator by the collaterals that we have, and the improvement, because you asked before also for also the contribution of the Greek state. The contribution of the Greek state is in many ways, but one of the ways is by stabilizing the economy and with the Greek bonds. You've seen the rally of GDPs the latest months. This is strong collateral for us to have extra liquidity if needed. So the Greek banks definitely have the liquidity to support these programs, and actually has been demonstrated already this year. In the first 9 months, the four systemic banks have a net delta of performing loans of close to 4.5 to 5 billion euros. This also shows that with the net delta in deposits of 13 billion euros, we utilized only a fraction of it. Besides that, as a last comment, I think that the Greek banks overall, not only they have the liquidity to support their own balance sheet, but they have the know-how and the ability to raise funds from other means. A great example is the Hellenikon project. The first phase of the financing for the Hellenikon project is close to 3 billion euros. Out of these 3 billion euros, 650 million euros can be raised through an equity capital raising, primarily from Greek but also international investors, through a bond which has been raised in the Greek market purely by private and institutional investors of 320 million euros, and then 1.7 billion euros have been underwritten with by two banks, Eurobank and Piraeus Bank, and I'm confident that Alpha Bank and National Bank of Greece will also join us in the future. Thank you, and thank you. Conscious of your time, thank you for your questions.
Thank you very much, Konstantinos. So we do have political support, we have financial support, so there's no better time to discuss, you know, with the project owner, to discuss with the man who is in the epicenter of the development, the brains of this project, Mr. Odisseas Athanasiou, working day and night, you know, on that. Mr. Athanasiou, Odisseas, I mean, I'm closing my eyes and I want to open them after 5 years. What would I see after 5 years? I mean, please tell us about your plan, and especially I would like to hear a few things about the development of the Metropolitan Park and the Coastal Front, but generally what I am going to see there after 5 years. Thank you.
I've closed my eyes too many times, and I think this time is for real that we're going to open them and see something. But before I start, let me say some thank you to Nikos and Olga Konosi for organizing for one more time, for one more year, this exceptional forum. I want to thank Kostas for the very, very kind words he put previously for Lambda and myself. I want to thank the minister and the whole government, and especially some people in the government, like Adon Juriadis, like Lina Mendoni, like Christos Tekouras, and the team, the core team, that has made it possible for us to think that this time we're going to open our eyes and see something for real, and not only in pictures like the one behind me. So what we intend, first of all, we have already started. And we started exactly because this time we see that things are moving. I think officially we're going to get in at the beginning of next year, sometime in the first months of the year. But exactly because we believe this is going to happen, we have started the works several months ago. In terms of real works, we started with demolitions. So the whole site that is looking towards Piraeus, where the ex-West airport used to be, the Olympiaki terminal, is all demolished. And at the same time, we're running all technical studies for the infrastructure works and many architectural studies for the landmark buildings, like for the high-rise tower on the coastline, like for the mall and the mixed-use tower on Miliagmenis Avenue, like the residential parts on the coastline. So we haven't shown these things to the public because we want to do this after the transfer of shares to have something official. And then we're going to, I think, have many nice surprises for Greeks to see and feel proud for what is going to happen in this country. Now, to be specific, in the first 5 years, we intend to develop the whole coastline. This is 3.5 kilometers length. And you know, one side is close to Alimu Avenue and the other side is close to Lifada. So we're going to develop there the, first of all, hotel on the Marina of Agios Kosmas, along with branded resi next to it, one nice Marina Galleria. And just above it, we're going to have the IRC that you talked about before, the Integrated Casino Resort, with this record amount that you said about the license. We feel very excited about this, and the cooperation with Mohegan and Yek. After this Marina Agios Kosmas development that I talked to you about, we're going to have the 200-meter first high-rise in Greece. It's going to be one of the tallest, actually it's going to be the tallest residential building on a coast in Mediterranean. And we're going to have a famous architect who's going to do this. We cannot announce the name yet, but we're going to do this very soon, as we said, after the transfer of shares. Then we're going to have a revamped 1.2 kilometers sandy beach that is going to connect this side of the development on the coastline with the other side, the one that is looking to Piraeus, let's say. And this is going to have another hotel, branded resi, the villas and condos. By the way, we had said some time ago that this is a project that is going to be like a beacon of foreign capital invested in Greece, and also an example of how we can do joint ventures. So other groups, credible groups, will participate. One, the beginning was done about 2 weeks ago by announcing our first joint venture with Temes, the company that has done Costa Navarino, that owns Hilton, that has done a cooperation with, that has a cooperation with La Young Group. And we're doing with them both hotels on the coastline and the brand resi that is adjacent to the hotels. This whole coastline is going to be developed by the end of 2024, beginning of 2025. And we are going to develop at the same time in these next 4 years, the park that is going to join the coastline with the part on Bouliagmenis Avenue. So you're going to have a total vertical park development connecting the sea with Vouliagmenis Avenue on the side where we're going to develop the mall and two high-rise towers, the first office towers in Greece. One is going to be an office hotel tower, and the other one is going to be a landmark office tower for the first company that is going to occupy this. Now, at the same time, in the first 5 years, we intend to bring school activity and create, hopefully, an R&D hub next to this commercial district where the offices and the malls are going to be. These are our plans for the first 5 years. We're talking about a capex of 1.5 billion euros, and this excludes the other billion euros that Mohigan and YEC have said that they are going to invest on the integrated resort. And on top of this, we're going to pay half a billion euros to the state for the first two installments of our payment. These are the plans.
This is indeed impressive, You know, one question, for all this to happen, appropriate infrastructure, such as, you know, roads, cables, networks, will have to be in place for the development of all these individual projects that you mentioned, be it the marina, be it the casino, be it, you know, whatever. I mean, can you please confirm that all this infrastructure will be in place, you know, for the other contractors to perform their work?
Actually, yeah. And before I say I commit to third parties who are going to invest in Hellinikon, first we have to commit for ourselves. Because as I told you, you know, more than 80% of the development is going to be done by Lambda. As you know, Lambda, first of all, is well-funded because we raised 650 million euros last year. You know about the bond, 320 million euros last July. And then we have this beautiful cooperation with Eurobank, who was the first bank that believed in us. And then Piraeus also got in the consortium. So we have another billion from there. So we're fully funded for all this five-year plan, including the infrastructure. The infrastructure is 400 million euros out of the numbers I gave you before. We are in full mode execution-wise to do this. We have to do this, and we have put actually a heavy focus on infrastructure because we know that we are going to obtain credibility through infrastructure. So when people are going to see the road network, the utility network, the telecommunication network, plus the park, are going to believe more in this project. So yes, we are committed.
And just one final word. I mean, the project, as you said, is symbolic. I mean, it should be considered as a beacon of innovation and environmental sustainability. Can you please add a few words on that? What do you have in mind? I heard something about R&D facilities, you know, next to the mall. That sounded, you know, really, really fantastic.
Yeah, we want to do this, and actually we have, our hopes have been enhanced by the recent movements by the government, like the Microsoft coming to Greece, the Astypalia project. These are new signs for Greece, that Greece has made the big move. It's a mindset thing to build credibility to foreign capital and foreign technology, that they are welcome to Greece, because if they believe in that, we have all the pillars for them to come here. We have infrastructure, we have fantastic weather, we have education. You know, we have all this. It was a change of mindset. So having said that, we have an area for an R&D hub, and we will be in talks with companies to do this, and the government, I'm sure, will be in there. But apart from this, we plan to do a smart city in Hellinikon, one of the first smart cities in the world. And I'm talking only about 5G and fiber optic network, but I'm talking about having sensors everywhere in order to run smart traffic management, smart waste management. Internet of Things will make every home, you know, utilize the latest modern technology. And we're going to have an operational control system that will take all the signs, all the data from the sensors, and give commands, so you have efficiency everywhere. Energy consumption, CO2 neutrality, and all these things that you know.
I'm sorry to interrupt. We have to go to the next session. This has been very interesting, very comprehensive, and of course, very compact. So thank you, Yanni. Thank you to the Minister, Konstantinos and Odisseas. And I hope we'll have the chance to host a specific one just on this project with videos, plans, and a lot more. So please forgive us for moving on to the next one.
Great news and great feedback. And see you next year, all in New York, you know, with physical presence. That was great. Thank you all very much.
Thank you. Bye.
Thank you to all. Thank you.